Howdy, boys. All right, we've moved over to the table saw today, so we've got some room to work. We're going to look at the Redding powder throw here and the RCBS Uniflow. And the idea this morning is to see, back here, that's some IMR 700X. It's a large flake powder, like it's a little bit bigger than unique. So I thought we'd use it to start. And let's see the difference between the small hole in this metering drum here. It measures 5/16 of an inch. And the larger hole in this Uniflow, and it measures just a couple hairs under a half an inch. So this one's almost double in measurement diameter than this one here. And I think what we're going to see is that this one with the smaller metering hole won't cut as bad as what this one here, this RCBS, because there's more interlocking surfaces as the metering hole here passes under the hopper hole here. And as they come into the last little radius, or the radians out there where they cross, that's where the cutting is happening. So if we've got a larger area, like on this one, passing, I tend to think that there would be more flakes of powder get caught in there along that radius. With a smaller one like the Redding, I think there are less of them that can get caught, and if it does cut, it would be less severe than what it is with this one. Now, I've never done this type of experiment before to see the difference, so we're all in uncharted territory, so let's see what happens. Both of them are set pretty close to each other. We're not after any specific amount of weight, because we're dropping by volume. Remember, we're filling a hole, but it just so happens that we check that volume by measuring by weight, and that's what we can do right here. You can see that scale good. You can see the numbers, I believe. All right, so I'm gonna get 10 throws out of this one, 10 out of this one. We'll notice how much trouble we have getting them with this large powder. All right. We're zeroed. Now I tend to tap a couple times at the bottom so I get everything to fall out. Okay, 3.7. I've already tapped on these hoppers to settle the powder. So it's not like I just poured it in there and just left it in a random stack. I can see that there's not much space between them. They're all compact pretty good. And that's generally how I'll start, is I always try and tap the powder reservoir. So they're both running even on that deal. 3.8 again. You can. 3.7. We're having a storm outside. It's nice to get some rain. 7.7 again. That's 3, 4, that's 5 throws. That's pretty impressive. And another 3.7. Tell me. 3.7. That's 3, 6, 8. We're going on our ninth throw. Now this one has an acrylic powder drop nozzle on it, and I think it's homemade. I got this thing used years ago, and I keep tapping real good because I notice this one here will kind of hang up powder. It's like it's trying to bridge, but I think it's just catching on a shelf where this plugs in. It's not really tapered real nice and clean. All right, 3.8 that time. 3.8, so that's 4, 8, 9. One more. You're gonna tell me 3.7 now. Okay, I'll take it. 3.7. Last throw. You gonna stick with your numbers? 3.8. All right, that's what it's gonna be. 3.8. There's 10 throws. Now, let's have a look at this RCBS. Remember, this one's got a 3/16 hole, no, 5/16 hole in the metering hole. That's just a 16th larger than a quarter, like a fat pencil. This one's got just under a half inch hole in it. So, measurement wise across the inside diameter, this is almost twice. Get a 4.1. Now 4.0. What are you gonna tell me here? 4.0. You notice I'm leaving my throws in the down position so that any vibrations on the table, say if I were loading right now and doing a batch in a tray or something and working a single stage press at the same time, any vibrations on this table, you see how it's disturbing the scale? That also, if you leave these in the up where you're calling for a charge, and you leave the handle up, or however you got your handle, but you leave the metering hole facing into the hopper, that little light vibration there tends to pack the powder tighter and tighter and tighter in the metering hole, so you'll get a heavier charge that way. That I've just learned from years of being a dummy on the loading bench, you know, and going, what the hell was that about? And finally figuring it out. All right, we got a 3.9 here. Now 4.0. As soon as I say it, it changes. What are you going to stick with? 4.0. It doesn't take much of a air moving across this to make that change. 3.9. All right, that's five throws. Looky here. I'm trying to, when I call for a charge, to slap it up there so it creates a little vibration, and as the powder drops into the metering hole, that vibration helps it to stack in there tight, you know, like laying frisbees on top of each other and not letting them get stacked at random. That's why I'm not very gentle at operating a powder throw. When I bring it up to call for a charge, by golly, I want that powder to be dropping and moving and packing in that little hole. All right, so what do we got here? Is that what you want to call it? 4.2. So far, we're not seeing a lot of chopping in here. This one was chopping real bad the other day with this same powder. 4.2, are ya? All right. That's 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is number 9, 4.2. Last throw. Hope on two. No. Yeah. Oh, now you're gonna say 4.3. All right. I thought you changed your mind. 4.2. Just my breath going across here. Cause that thing to change, or maybe I'm bumping the table. Yeah, might be just me bumping the table. 4.2. All right, let's look at what we found out here. Okay. 10 throws with the Redding with the small diameter metering hole in it. I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I got 7 at 3.7 grains. And I got 3 at 3.8 grains. And in that short little test, we've only got a plus or minus. Now, you couldn't call it a plus or minus. It's just a minus 1/10 change overall. OA, overall, see, overall change, minus 1. All right, on the Uniflow, 1, 2, 3, 4 of them at 4.0. I've got 1 at 3.9. I have 1 at 4.1, and then 1, 2, 3, 4 at 4.2. All right, so that would be 10 throws, 7 threes, 10 throws. Okay, we're even Steven. On this one, our low is 3.9, our high is 4.2. So that's a, how can we look at this? It's a 3/10 overall change. So depending on whether we were trying to get a 4-grain powder drop for this cartridge we're gonna load, and then it would go as high as 4.2 and then drop as low as 3.9 in 10 throws. Now just think what it's gonna do over, say 100 throws, or 200 or 300, however many you batch load. Some of you guys that do batch loading on a single stage load voluminous trays full, you know. I used to do that back in the day before I got a turret, you know, and then after that I got a progressive to work with. But I know that just starting out, you can load lots and lots and lots of ammo with a tray and a single stage. So what I'm trying to point out is with this larger hole here, we didn't see much chopping, but we did see a 3/10 overall change from high to low on what this measure is throwing. Now this one with a smaller hole, about half the size of this one, this Redding, we saw a 1/10 overall change. That's, for this flake powder, that's amazing. I think that's awesome. Now, here's what I'm making of this. Like I said earlier, when those holes in the metering drum and the hole in the upper part of the hopper pass each other, a larger hole on this one, this RCBS, is going to capture more flakes inside there. Because remember, this is solid powder all the way down to the face of that drum. So we're turning under that stack of powder. And so anything that's caught up at the edge of the hole, that it's got to be sheared off or pushed out of the way. So what I'm looking at here and what I'm starting to think is with the Uniflow, we got more of an arc, a larger, wider arc, so we can trap more, and so more grains are moving out of the metering hole or getting pressed in a little tighter. We didn't see it chopping a lot, but I think that's the reason that we see a 3/10 overall change in just those 10 throws. I think with the Redding, with the smaller hole, that even though it's a larger flake powder, we're seeing that there's less of the grains having to pass as the metering holes pass to go on to the delivery. We see less disturbance in that metered column of powder inside the drum. So that's just my take on it. You know, you guys are going to have to make some comments, because I'm no scientist, and you can sure as hell tell that. Now I'm going to use this same setup, and we're going to try some other powders. Eagle Eye is really into the stick and extruded, so we want to look at those too. He's not got any experience with these type of throws. He's been using a lot of Lee, and I think Uncle Jim just bought him a Lyman brass Smith. So now that brass Smith just happens to have the same size hole as this RCBS Uniflow. All right, enough said. We'll move on to another powder, and we'll just see how this goes.